Let's take a look at some of the big moments that happened in our first round. Atrocitus, ooh, this DR Viking was looking pretty good against Noble Beyond Toxin, but Beyond Toxin is not out of this yet. We'll see a Scarecrow a little bit later. And Zyfox with Flash, the beginning against OD Full Auto's Deadshot, was pretty effective, and the Gorilla Grodd performance from Skadar was most impressive to all of us, but Game Freaks was able to take that series, and in the end, the reverse sweep Grape comes back from 0-2 and takes the game against Poison Ivy. Congratulations to those players so far. I'm looking forward to seeing how the rest of tonight's region is going to play out, but we do have an update for other regions as well. Evan, let's go ahead and talk about Seattle.
Seattle, where we did see on broadcast another really good Firestorm player, but he's still stuck down there in eighth place, Mr. Shijinky Dink. Now, Tiger has that 500-point lead just like Nubcake, so Tiger almost definitely guaranteed for that regional finals, while the rest of top four sounds like Paws, Too Easy, and I Am the Batman looking pretty solid in their spots, too.
I Am the Batman, one of my favorite names in all of Hometown Heroes. Let's take a look at Dallas. Our friends over in Texas, we got Chaotic Ominous taking the lead so far with 420 points. Handy Savage, speaking of great names, 390. Maddox, 315. Peanut, 275. And rounding out that mid-tier block of 255 and 225 and 155 are some other good players that we got to see as well on the broadcast. Tonight's bracket, still not over yet. We got OD Full Auto versus Game Freaks, and then Noble Beyond Toxin versus Grape in the loser bracket. We'll continue with that section of the bracket, and then a little bit later, we'll see who's going to make it from the winner's side of DR Viking versus Zyfox. This next matchup, though, OD Full Auto versus Game Freaks. We're seeing a Scarecrow against a Deadshot.
And surprisingly enough, throughout the entirety of this season, we haven't seen these two players play in bracket even a single time. So this will be the first time that they've met in tournament, and we're seeing an interesting pick from Full Auto. We're seeing actually the same pick that we saw from Alcatraz, which was a surprise pick on stream. So unsurprisingly, a lot of the OD players probably have practiced a lot of the same counter picks. We've seen a lot of Deadshot from them. We've now seen a lot of Cyborg from them. And I think they're just ready for certain other matchups. I want to know, though, why Cyborg in this matchup over Deadshot?
We're going to find out. Scarecrow from Game Freaks is able to get the first onslaught of damage for over 306, including a couple strikes here and there. And now Cyborg from OD Full Auto was in the corner, but there's a couple trades from his side. Summons the Mother Box.
Oh, and this is where he wants to be. As soon as he can start setting up all of his zoning tools, it's going to get very, very scary for Game Freaks. But nice usage of the blast to stop the projectiles. That's going to allow him to build at least a little bit more meter as he gets in and take a lot less chip.
The Roomba!
The Doomba!
The Doomba!
And he had to respect that. That was a tough situation in Full Auto with a nice lead.
I love the laugh. And now Game Freaks trying to even up that health, puts OD Full Auto into the corner, and now we have a tie game for game one.
And just in one exchange, ties the whole thing up. Very impressive, but that is, whoa, nice conversion. What's he gonna do? Is he gonna get a mix up? He is, fakes the cross up, but still, very nice setup.
The mobility from both of these players right now is pretty, not excessive, impressive, but somebody's going to have to calm down a bit and try to land some of these strikes. It's not going to be OD Full Auto and his Cyborg. Game Freaks gets the overhead. That's the opening he needed.
Now for the big guns.
And that was a very smart clash. I don't think he's going to get another chance to after that. There are a lot of opportunities for unclashable damage.
15% health regen. Couple more long range hits from Cyborg, but Game Freaks gets a connection.
The advantage of this Ender is the fact that it restands them and gives you a huge amount of advantage. And now the lead is in Game Freak's favor. And two sweeps in a row is what it took. Taking that lead back so quickly and closing it out.
Wow, game one going to Game Freaks. That comes down to optimization in the moment. What I mean by that is he knew the exact placing he was in, kept doing the same thing until it stopped working. It worked all the way through till the end. Some good advice I have for the professor, Brett Beeling: keep doing the same thing until your opponent gets frustrated and tries something else. So that definitely worked for Game Freaks.
Yeah, and sweep is a very safe option in that scenario because Cyborg doesn't actually have a true wake up except for his command grab, but his command grab is hot. So using any sort of low attack will low profile anything that he could have done on wake up. And on top of that, Scarecrow, the only character in the game with a plus on block sweep. So overall, forcing Full Auto to go back to his main, which is overall, I don't feel like this is any worse of a pick than Cyborg was.
Dead shot from long range again, utilizing the zoning that everybody knew he was good at from Dame 1, but you can't discount the mix-up potential, but still staying in range, and there's the potential teleport coming from Scarecrow, but OD Full Auto was ready for it.
And Full Auto is named Full Auto because he did play Full Auto Jackie in Mortal Kombat X. So choosing a character that shoots a lot of guns is not surprising at all.
That was a perfect round, ladies and gentlemen. Still staying at range. Game Freak's slowly trying to move in.
And the big issue here is that even though he's not taking any chip damage, Game Freak is allowing Full Auto to build a lot of meter, which is going to open him up for opportunities just like that, where the meter burn low rifle pushed back and gave him even more space to build meter. So right now, we haven't seen a single bit of damage. We haven't seen Game Freak touch Full Auto at all.
This is so frustrating.
Oh,
there we go. There's the opener he needed.
And now if he wants to win the season, he's going to have to not let Full Auto get out at all. He's going to have to land every mix-up. This is a great start. This should be a lot of damage. It'll put him within range to maybe kill with one more mix-up. Oh, no conversion again.
Oh, throw.
And a great choice, throwing it back in the corner. And the sweep, wow, he took one whole life bar without taking any damage. He's got great positioning. He could do it, but oh, not if he gets knocked out like this. This is going to be tough.
Oh, he lands, and there's the chip. And dead shot, able to take game number two. Good choice from OD Full Auto.
Yeah, looking very, very solid in this pick. I'm really surprised to the fact that he chose Cyborg. It really looks like he's more comfortable with this character and more comfortable in this matchup with this character. So maybe he was just trying something. Like I said, a lot of players this week may be trying new characters just in preparation for the upcoming patch.
Exactly.
Deadshot, he's one of the characters that we see, we're seeing some changes, especially to his up close game get normalized. So maybe he wants a character that's a little bit better up close and at zoning. Maybe that's why he's trying out Cyborg. But overall, you got to go back to your guns. You're literally your guns.
Got to stick to your guns. Oh, the low. It hurts me every time.
it's such a great normal.
It is. All right, now we're in the same situation Game Freaks was last game, trying to push forward against OD Full Auto zoning. It's not an easy task. Every time he fires, he gets meter. With one bar of meter, he's able to do the low rifle shot.
And low rifle is essentially inescapable, and it also pushes you back so far, does a ton of chip, just gives him more space. Right now, oh, wow, Full Auto choosing to go in, not the best choice. Now this is gonna be a great—
Oh, the horror has been activated. Scarecrow was able to get one hit off OD Full Auto, but he's back in the same spot.
Oh, he is, but he's so close. And this corner, we've seen how good Full Auto is at using the interactable there. So that's something that Game Freak is really going to have to watch out for, if he can even get back in.
There's the reload. Oh, no, oh, so close.
And wasn't able to connect it because Deadshot actually ducks during the animation of his low rifle. And so he actually low profiled the jump in.
And there is that beautiful interactable play. Two jumping hits, and there is the opening for Game Freaks. Takes the health bar. That's where Game Freaks wants to be. The challenge is getting there.
Oh, and no punish on the teleport, but Full Auto is still in a really good position as he's got so much space to walk back. And there we go. Punishes it this time.
Are you scared yet?
I am.
Eat lead, sucker.
Perfect response from Deadshot.
Oh, and look how much damage Game Freak's had. That wasn't even a very damaging situation to Clash. He clashed the second to last hit of the combo. Instead, he's taken so much damage because Full Auto was able to build so much meter within his zoning. So Full Auto taking that last one very quickly at the end. But, you know, every single time that we see Game Freaks get in, it goes in his favor. It's just how many times can he get in a match?
That's the struggle. The struggle is real for Scarecrow, but if he can do it, it's. I see him kind of debating if he's going to use the teleport to get behind or if he's just going to try to go for that rush movement, that leap, that headbutt, but the leap is either too far away or he tries to go for a jump in and with the overhead attack, but then Deadshot is able to get the little rifle, as you said. So I'm even taking notes here as a Catwoman player going, all right, well, I haven't faced a Deadshot like this for a while. I'm not going to have armor for Cat Dash, so what are the best options here? This is one option. Game Freaks is going to change it up to Atrocitus.
Now, Atrocitus is known as one of the characters that does pretty well against Deadshot. Every time that he gets Dexter, oh no, you know what? He faked us out.
He
wanted to get me halfway through the explanation and then say, nah, just kidding. Mm-hmm. Waste your breath. But, you know, that wouldn't have been a bad choice. But I feel like, honestly, again, every single time he gets in, he almost gets an entire life bar. So if he can just get in maybe one or two more times than he has been, he could still easily take the game. Oh, but this stage has some of the most powerful interactables in the entire game, as we might see right now. We've seen that Full Auto is so great at using interactables right here. He could use it. Oh, he tried to use it, actually got stuffed out of it. But each one of the gargoyles allows him to set up an unblockable bomb that launches the opponent.
Great defense coming from Game Freaks. He gets the sweep, but is not able to convert into a combo. Did a little bit of damage, enough for Full Auto to reorganize his thoughts and his advance here. That's the armor. Push block.
Oh, and this is almost guaranteed chip. I think I would have liked to see him teleport. Even if he got punished for the teleport, he would have been out of the corner, got a little bit more advantage.
It's taking the damage, but getting the proximity, and that's the name of the game right now for Game Freaks. He's able to take 437 damage off of Odie Full Auto, and he has another opening, and he's going to get the health bar. And even though Game Freaks is down a game, we're just about tied when it comes to the health bars here.
Yeah, and you see, he got in once, just did two combos, tied the entire thing up, but now he's got to get back in again.
There's a gargoyle, and he advances forward.
It was so smart to use the meter on the gargoyle that allowed him to absorb the gunshot and then get in on Full Auto. And now look at him, he's got the life advantage. He's going to get an OP situation off of this knockdown.
Oh, he goes for the sweep, but he gets the high strike as well. You're a real and the clash.
That's the point.
And now there's going to be a little bit of life back for Full Auto, but the advantage, the screen positioning, it's all going to be in Game Freak's favor. Oh, but again, Full Auto's favorite interactable, anyone that you can jump off of and dive kick in the corner. So this is going to be, it's going to be tough to bait all that, and he's slowly taking life lead back just with chip alone.
Well, we finally found what terrifies Scarecrow, and it's Deadshot from a distance. Oh, he's still not able to get through that interactable play, and Full Auto is mere health points away from taking it with one more rifle shot. And Full Auto is going to return.
Deadshot wins.
To take the win, 3-1.
And it was a beautiful read at the very end. He tried to stop him from using the dive kick interactable, but unfortunately, I think he just used the wrong jump attack. A jump two would have been a much better disjointed hitbox. It would have been able to counter poke him out of the air, but instead he went for jump three. Doesn't really have that upwards hitbox that jump two would have, and instead got dive kicked himself, knocked full screen, and then had to take that chip, which secured Full Auto the win.
We do have to say goodbye to Game Freaks, but we saw some great Scarecrow play coming from him. And as you said, you know, these interactable plays create that opening, or at least create that shield that you need in order to advance.